Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's tutorial is a half a pear style. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. If you're new, make sure to subscribe, click that bell as always, and let's get started. To begin this hairstyle, I'm going to part my hair down the middle to split my hair into two equal sides. Then I'm going to create another part line on the right side of the middle part to divide out a 1-inch section of hair for my first braid. Picking up a small slice of hair near the forehead, I'm going to divide this into three smaller pieces. I'm creating a French braid, so I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand and incorporate new sections of hair into the braid from along this section that's been divided out. So I'm crossing one side strand over the middle, then crossing the other side strand over the middle. Once I've started the braid, I'm going to begin picking up small pieces of hair from along the sides of the braid and bring these into the braid by adding them into the side strands once they're crossed over the middle section. I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair, crossing it over as well, adding it into the new middle strand. Then I'm crossing the opposite side strand over the middle, picking up a new piece from along the outside of the braid and incorporating it into the middle strand as well. I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new piece of hair and crossing it over, incorporating it into the braid. Then I'm crossing the opposite side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair, crossing it over into the middle, adding it into that side strand as well. I'm going to repeat this pattern, continuing the French braid along this small section of hair at the top of my head and working my way back until the braid reaches near the crown of my head. I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new piece of hair and crossing it over, incorporating it into the braid. Then I'm crossing the opposite side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair, crossing it over into the middle, adding it into that side strand as well. Once the braid reaches far enough back to where I'll want my bun to sit, I'm going to stop incorporating new sections of hair into the braid and just continue braiding the section in a regular 3-strand braid before sliding a bobby pin over the end so I can go back and work with it later. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps as before and create a second French braid next to the first on the left side of my part. I'm going to create another part line on the left side of the middle part to divide out a 1-inch section of hair for my braid. Picking up a small slice of hair near the forehead, I'm going to divide this into three smaller pieces. I'm creating a French braid, so I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand and incorporate new sections of hair into the braid from along this section that's been divided out. So I'm crossing one side strand over the middle, then crossing the other side strand over the middle. Once I've started the braid, I'm going to begin picking up small pieces of hair from along the sides of the braid and bring these into the braid by adding them into the side strands once they're crossed over the middle section. I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair, crossing it over as well, adding it into the new middle strand. Then I'm crossing the opposite side strand over the middle, picking up a new piece from along the outside of the braid and incorporating it into the middle strand as well. I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new piece of hair and crossing it over, incorporating it into the braid. Then I'm crossing the opposite side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair, crossing it over into the middle, adding it into that side strand as well. I'm going to repeat this pattern, continuing the French braid along this small section of hair at the top of my head and working my way back until the braid reaches near the crown of my head. Once the braid reaches far enough back to where I'll want my bun to sit, I'm going to stop incorporating new sections of hair into the braid before sliding a bobby pin over the end so I can go back and work with it later. Once both braids are done, I'm going to combine them together and tie them off using a clear elastic band. On the last wrap of the elastic, though, I'm going to pull the hair partway through to create a little loop, and I want my ends to be facing down towards my face. They'll be easier to wrap this way. Now I'm going to take a second elastic band and tie this over the ends of the hair that are sticking out from the bun. Then I'm going to split the hair between the elastics, and I'm going to flip the ends a couple times through the gap so the sides are twisted. Then I'm actually going to spin the hair a couple times as well. Then I'm going to take this and wrap it over the looped section so the hair is being wrapped around the sides of the bun. Now I'm just going to detail the bun a little bit. So I'm going to pull the hair elastic tight so it fits around the looped bun. And I'm going to pull on the edges of the bun to fluff it up a bit. Slide a bobby pin into the bun so it's more flush with my head and will stay in place throughout the day. Then I'm going to finish the style by spraying it with hairspray and smoothing down any shorter pieces that might be sticking out to smooth down the style the best that I can. That wraps up today's video. Let me know what you think about this hairstyle down below in the comment section, and I will see you next time.